Better buckle up, because we are back with a few more shocks under our belts. Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for another Top 10 Scariest Scenes from Non-Horror Movies. If you didn't see a moment you thought should be on this list, be sure to check out our first list of the Top 10 Scariest Scenes from Non-Horror Movies.
Get out! You see it! Get out!
Number 10, His Fangs Are Sharp, Jumanji.
Jumanji.
Many family films have been considered unsuitable and disturbing for children, but none flows like a horror movie for kids quite like Jumanji. The intense 90s adventure classic follows Robin Williams as a man who gets sucked into a sadistic board game, literally.
Suddenly I feel right at home.
In a world where creatures come to life with every roll of the dice, most memorable is when the children land on the wrong spot and are suddenly attacked by a lion. Featuring one of the game's many man-eating creatures, this scene had us checking our closets for years to come. Number 9, Night on Bald Mountain, Fantasia.
The Night on Bald Mountain by one of Russia's greatest composers, Modest Mussorgsky.
Many grew up thinking this experimental and one-of-a-kind animated classic was for kids, and although some parts are curiously strange, confirmation that this wasn't your typical Disney fare came with its final sequence. Animators took the already frightening Mussorgsky composition Night on Bald Mountain and invented even more terrifying imagery to put behind it. We follow the devil Chernabog as he summons demons, ghosts, and witches in an orgy of madness and celebration. Although the classical music and animation are fascinating and have captivated audiences for the better part of a century, the subject matter will always be the stuff of nightmares. Number 8, Sleep on It, The Godfather.
Khartoum.
Being one of the most celebrated crime thrillers of all time, The Godfather will undoubtedly have a few unnerving scenes. Likewise, by being the don of a famous crime family, Vito Corleone is bound to have to take care of business in unnerving and disturbing ways.
I'm gonna make him an offer he can't refuse.
Hollywood studio head Jack Waltz made the mistake of ignoring the mob's pleas to give Don Vito's godson, pop singer Johnny Fontaine, a shot at the big time.
Now you get the hell out of here!
And therefore he wakes up with a surprise in his bed. This unforgettable and shocking scene builds up to an unexpected climax we won't soon forget. And neither will poor Jack. Number 7. Beware the Wheelers, Return to Oz.
Help me to rise.
L. Frank Baum's universe is no stranger to disturbing imagery geared towards children. This fantasy adventure follows Dorothy as she finds her way back to Oz, only to find it in tatters.
Come here, chicken!
Ah, a wheeler!
In one part of the deserted land, Dorothy runs into the Wheelers, mammals who have wheels for limbs and carry creepy masks reminiscent of the Wicked Witch's flying monkeys. As if the cabinets of disembodied heads the princess keeps and all of Dorothy's friends being turned to stone wasn't enough.
They've all been turned to stone.
80s kids also know to beware the Wheelers because of this flick. Number 6, Final Transformation, Black Swan.
I was just trying to be perfect like you.
Nina Sayers will do absolutely anything to get the role she wants in her ballet company. And this movie is all about the artist's determination. In a film filled with creepy moments and body horror transformations, it isn't until her final confrontation with Lily, whom Nina claims is trying to steal her spotlight, where that determination is unparalleled.
He made me your alternate.
because just in case.
The sudden violent attack, chilling transformation, and shocking climax, followed by possibly the creepiest dance routine ever put on film, will leave you wondering how ballet could ever scare you this much. Number 5. Large Marge, Pee-wee's Big Adventure. How can a film with such childish glee and comedy scare the pants off people?
Thanks for stopping.
When Pee-wee goes cross-country to find his stolen bicycle, he meets many bizarre characters, but none is as strange as Large Marge.
On this very night, 10 years ago,
when the trucker picks him up on the highway, she decides to casually share a story about a violent accident she witnessed.
I saw the worst accident I ever seen.
With Pee-wee sensing that something is off, Marge gives us a jump scare for the ages. Although this scene seemed to come out of nowhere, we would later learn to love it as a Tim Burton signature.
I know you are, but what am I?
You're a nerd.
I know you are, but what am I?
You're an idiot.
I know you are, but what am I?
I know you are, but what am I?
Number 4, A Dream at Winkies, Mulholland Drive.
This Winkies.
Okay. Why this Winkies?
David Lynch is the king of metaphor and surrealism. He also knows how to scare us.
Just forget you ever saw it. It's better that way.
In a film about Hollywood making dreams come true, we forget that some of these dreams can turn to nightmares.
Beautiful evening.
Yeah.
In one of the famous disconnected scenes, we listen to a man at a diner describe a terrifying dream he had.
I had a dream about this place.
The hideous face he encountered, and the awful feeling he still can't shake.
There's a man in back of this place.
Eerie like only Lynch can do, the man starts to realize that maybe he can't escape the nightmare he built for himself. Number 3, Tell It to My Heart, Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom. Steven Spielberg and the Indiana Jones franchise are no strangers to thrills and chills. This second installment and prequel finds Indy helping a small Indian village investigate a possible ancient cult for kidnapping their children.
It's a thuggy ceremony. They're worshiping Kali.
His theory is proven correct when he and his team stumble upon the thuggy cult, led by the imposing and bloodthirsty high priest Mola Ram. What they find here is a violent ritual filled with smoke, skulls, fiery pits, and human sacrifice that left many movie watchers covering their eyes, and all of us knowing that Indy was in big trouble. Number 2, Pretty Mouth, Deliverance.
What the hell you think you're doing?
Uncomfortable does not begin to describe our runner-up as we follow four city guys and old friends down the river on a camping trip to enjoy a bit of nature's magic before the area gets flooded.
You done taken a wrong turn.
Things are less than magical when two of the friends, after having been split up from the group, run into some very unsavory village folk.
He got a little pretty mouth, ain't he?
Memorably cringeworthy, the two are attacked, tormented, and one of them is even raped as they pray for their friend's swift return.
Come on, squeal! Squeal!
This is the turning point that changes this male bonding trip into a violent fight for survival. Oh! Before we reveal our top pick, here are some honorable mentions.
Ready? Get her!
Oh, I can't.
Yes, and now the beam will rid you of your fears.
your thoughts, your vital essence.
Number 1. Sloth, 7.
There are 7 deadly sins, Captain.
Detectives Mills and Somerset are trying to piece together the details and motives behind a string of murders when they stumble upon their third victim.
Oof. Jesus.
When it seems like the serial killer is targeting victims based on the 7 deadly sins, they find this one confined to his bed and left to rot, representing the sin of sloth.
Sloth.
Quietly disturbing in its own right, we get the scare of our lives when, upon closer inspection, the victim is miraculously still alive.
He's alive!
A jump scare that gets us every time. It is gruesome, grisly, wholly unexpected, and unforgettable. Do you agree with our list?
No!
What other scenes scared the pants off you?
We'll get back to you. What?
For more chilling top 10s published every day, be sure to subscribe to WatchMojo.com.
Is it safe?